हेलो, दिस इज स्वप्निल ममानी, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस महिला महाविद्यालय तासगांव। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द इनलाइन फंक्शन एंड द यूज ऑफ स्कोप रिजोल्यूशन ऑपरेटर। डबल कोलन इज द स्कोप रिजोल्यूशन ऑपरेटर इन C++। इन द C++ द स्कोप रिजोल्यूशन ऑपरेटर इज यूज्ड टू डिफाइन ए फंक्शन आउटसाइड ए क्लास और व्हेन वी वांट टू यूज ग्लोबल वेरिएबल्स बट आल्सो हैज ए लोकल वेरिएबल विद द सेम नेम। In that situation, we are going to use scope resolution operator. Now let us see one example. Like previous lectures example, class test integer ab semicolon. These instance variables are by default private because private no need to declare. It is by default private. Public colon void add a is equal to 10, b equal to 20 semicolon c out addition equal to a plus b. a plus b semicolon. Class complete semicolon. Now void main. Clear screen as usual, like previous all lectures. Get ch, same for all programs. Now create one object for test class. To use public methods or public variables, we have to use the object. To access all variables and the functions, use object dot. For errors occurs because include spelling is mistakenly here. So mistake is here in include spelling. To clear this, again errors. Main spelling is also correct. Addition equal to 30. Now this example, see void add. In this example, put the word inline before the function. Output is same like as usual. In C++, a function definition in a class definition is an inline function definition even without the use of the inline specifier. Means all the function is already inlined. Inlined function means a function which has a single line statements, not has a jumping loops. That function is called a inline. All the statements we can see in the add function, all the statements are single line statements. So already this function is a inline. No need to declare as a inline before the void add. But it is okay when we declare this. Now see what is the use of scope resolution operator. Now add void show method to know the inline function is how works. Inline void show. In this function we are going to display 1 to 10 numbers by using for loop. For integer I equal to 1, I less than equal to 10i plus plus c out I. Here we can see there is a for statements used to print 1 to 10. Means here jumping statements are here. So we can see the warning message here, function containing for are not extended inline. So we can't extend the jumping statements function as a inline. Function containing for are not explained inline. Means all the functions declared in the class are inline declarations. If we have to use the functions with the jumping statements, we have to declare that all functions outside the class. To declare this function outside the class, we have to use scope resolution operator. At the outside of the class, test scope resolution operator show. This means show function is in the scope of test class. Here only prototyping, and outside the class whole body of the function is available to code. Now compile this and run this. Class test, two functions are here, success. This is the scope resolution operator. Show is in the scope of test. Void show is declared in the class and body of the function is declared outside the class. Before we running, we have to call the show function. Integer temporary, now no necessary to use temporary variable. Before this, check and call the show function. Is output is okay or not? Here is the output. For add, addition equal to 30, and for show 1 to 10 numbers. Use the next line to show correct output here. In double code, have to use next line slash n. You can see addition equal to 30 and 1 to 10 numbers. If a function is inline, the compiler places a copy of code of that function at each point where the function is called at compile time. Now learn with one variable temporary equal to 100. See out temporary is the instance variable of the test class. Here our error is occurred because temporary is not the accessible. So temporary is not accessible. Why? Undefined simple temporary. Now see what will happen. Temporary is the private member, so not accessible outside the class. So check as a public, then what see what will happen with the temporary. Integer temporary, temporary is the public variable, but undefined a symbol temporary. All the public variables or the functions we can use only dot operator, by using dot operator with their respect of objects of that particular class. So object dot temporary we can use if the temporary is a public. The private, if the temporary is a private, we can't use because it is not accessible. Now see the output, temporary equal to 100. It is correct. Now again see what happens with the temporary if we declare in the global section. Now check, before this, put the add function outside the class, like show method. Inline void add. Now see here we never used a scope restriction operator. It will occurs error after some time. Now see what will happen. Undefined symbol A and defined symbol B. Because A and B is the private variables of the class test. If we are going to create one object here, then also we can't access this A and B. Now check, we can't access here A and B like this also. OB.A plus OB.B, but it will occurs error. A is not accessible, B is not accessible, because these variables are the private variables of the test class. So when we are going to use this, it has to be a public or the private members. Now what is missing here? The scope resolution operator, because we never used here scope resolution operator. After this it is success. In this way the scope resolution operators work. Instead of scope resolution operator, we can't use the public methods or variables. Object.temporary. Now check, test scope resolution operator temporary equal to 100. It will also occurs error here. Remember, the temp cannot be used without an object, because temporary is a public variable declared in the class test. So it has to be used with the object. So instead of this, when we declared in the private section, also we cannot use here. Remember, temporary cannot be used without an object. So error occurs here. When we declare this as in a global section, now see, put comment here for also private and public variable, integer temporary. We cannot use temporary with the scope resolution operator because it is a global. We have to use directly as this temporary equal to 100. Here also test temporary equal to 100. That program is successfully running. So today we learn about the inline function and the scope resolution operator here. In this way, from tomorrow's lecture, we are going to learn about the classes and the objects and all the functions with the scope resolution operator. Thank you. To get the more videos of this series, please like, share and subscribe. And please do not forget to press the bell icon to view latest videos. Thank you.